I had way too much fun doing this. Way too much fun. What's up, world? I'm Dr. Nick Spurlock, herbalist, acupuncturist, and end-of-life doula. But today, I'm wearing my queer advocacy hat. Because this weekend is very special. October 11th is National Coming Out Day. Coming Out Day occurs in October every year. So I'm throwing a Coming Out Day Halloween party! Yes! For just myself, really, because 2020 and we're living in the time of COVID. But I don't care. I'm gonna celebrate anyway, and I'm gonna share it with all of you. So I need you to be excited with me in spirit. Come on, get excited. All right, let's go put on our party outfits. And I've got no defense for it. I'm a queer witch. Duh. First things first, I need tea. Hibiscus is fun. Nice and red. Today is a day to be your fullest, unapologetic, weirdo self. And let your freak flag fly. Have fun, be you, don't give a damn what anyone thinks. Haters gonna hate. You know why? We're over here having fun, being bold, living our grandest life, being the cosmic queens that we were always meant to be, and they hate us because they ain't us. They aren't free. They're trapped in a world of expectations and societal norms, and they can all suck it. The first Coming Out Day was in 1988, based on the idea that the best way to advocate for civil rights is to be seen. A lot of people think they don't know any of us, when in fact, everyone knows at least one of us. Because when they know who we are, it breaks down the stereotypes and misinformation. Let's get the cauldron out so we can get our potion boiling. The beautiful thing about our LGBTQI+ community is that we are everyone. We are everywhere. We're in every group, every nationality, every racial identity, every religion, every socioeconomic class, every age. Our community is inherently diverse by its very nature. We are beautiful, every one of us. Time for cookies. And I'm gonna make them colorful, just cause. As someone who is both a medical provider and a queer person, I understand firsthand how going to see a doctor can be very unpleasant for queer people. The system wasn't designed for us. Just know that there are providers out there like me, more and more of them every year, where you will absolutely be safe and respected no matter who you are. I call this my candy corn cookie jar. Time for some nonsensical fun. I had way too much fun doing this. And now I'm going to make cupcakes. Can you tell that I love baking? Who is your queer rights hero? We aren't taught queer history in school, so you may not know any off the top of your head. I'll help you out. Kathy Kosachenko and Harvey Milk were some of the first openly gay elected officials in the United States. Jane County, the first trans rock and roll star. Dan Savage started the It Gets Better movement to prevent teen suicide. Billie Jean King is a tennis Hall of Famer. Megan Rapinoe is a beast on the football field. How about Alexander the Great? And one that's relevant now, Pete Buttigieg. He is the first gay person to run for president of the United States and the first to win delegates in the process. Like he was actually in the primary and he actually had a shot. He and Bernie Sanders basically tied in winning the Iowa caucus in 2020. That's a huge deal. For us as a community, he is a voice of reason in a tumultuous time, and he gives me hope for future leadership. I need more tea. This time, we'll do butterfly pea. And here's a simple chemistry magic trick. Oh, wow. Pumpkin time! And just for fun, I'm gonna carve this pumpkin using nothing but a drill. Did you know that there are 11 million LGBTQ adults eligible to vote in the 2020 election? Did you know that there are 57 million pro-equality voters in the United States? Do you know what would happen if all 57 million of us voted? We would win. We would win by a landslide. We would have housing protections, job protections, healthcare protections. And it's not just about the LGBTQ folks, because remember, we're everyone. We could help win the fight against racial injustice. We could help prioritize climate change measures. We could help end medical bankruptcy. All of this we could do if every one of us made our voices heard with our vote. Ta-da! This is my coming out day pumpkin. It's quite lantern-esque. Ooh, I like it. Dang, that came out awesome. Have you carved your first pumpkin of the season yet? This is a perfect time. Share it with the hashtag coming out day pumpkin.
Thanks, Ibu. You are such a good girl.
Do you see the stunning majesty of this?
Mwah. No. Mwah. No. Mm.